Some of the content in this game might not be suitable for all ages. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome to Let's Play The Supper, which is a very short adventure horror game by Octavi Navarro. He's put out quite a few of these, along with three games, the Midnight Scenes games, which I'm going to be putting up videos of that as well. Just not sure what order I'm doing this all in, because I gotta fit material just for 3 days. And then some other stuff starts going up. Anyway, you can get this for free on Steam. It came out in 2020. Yeah, it's free. Options. I put the volume down, so you can hear me. It tends to be very loud unless you turn it way down. Sure, like the other games. So, new game. I haven't really played any of this. Just looked around a bit. Miss Appleton. I don't think she's human. She's green. Wake up. And I don't know who's talking. I'm sorry, Miss Appleton. I know your old bones are tired. Well, she's got no legs. Well, those are arms on the side, so she's missing the bottom part of her legs. Things were so much easier before, weren't they? But there's no time to rest. Look at the time. Customers will be arriving any minute now, and we don't want to keep them waiting with empty bellies, do we? Alright, so I looked around here a bit. Oh, empty pot. I didn't see that. Doesn't want that. Special sauce. Embers. Swordfish recipes list. Solid wax. He shrugs. Whoop. Fire tongs. So I've done this. Now I have fire tongs with ember. Empty pot. We don't want to put it in there. Or in there. Or in there. So, and then the recipes list. This is as far as I got. I read this. Recipes du jour. Pigeon a la sauce rosée. One wild pigeon covered with special sauce. Spicy red swordfish. One blue swordfish tail. Add one chili pepper. Cover with special sauce. Hand and tongue stew. One plump human hand and one slimy tongue covered with special sauce. What's in the special sauce? The fire tongs are still here, even though I have them. Dining room? Alright, we want to turn on the candle, or light the candle. I know, it's dark in here. Some light will make the place much more inviting. Alright, so we're gonna obviously light it. They obviously light it with the ember. Let's just look around a little bit on that one too. A doorbell. Outside. Pigeon? Cannot reach. The Joyous Lobster Inn. Best place in town for a snack. Not if they serve human hands and stuff. I'm just exploring, guys, and we're gonna light up the place soon. Oh, there's a boat. Are these where our customers will be coming from? Rope ladder? Fisherman. No time to hang out with your friends, Miss Appleton. We have work to do. Okay. I'll burn him. No. Well, she gets around pretty quickly. despite everything. Is that the bird making that noise? Like, eh, noise. A lever. We don't know what to do with the lever. A jail door? Who's in jail? I don't think there's anything to do but light this stuff. Well, that sounds spooky all of a sudden. Well done, Miss Appleton. Now we just have to wait for some starving souls to pass by. We light the other one too? Okay. Doorbell. Okay, it works. Empty water jug. Dip it in the special sauce. No, we don't want to do that. Swordfish tail. I couldn't look at that before. Huh. She pet it? Ah. It looks like it moved a little, didn't it? Maybe because she pulled it. Okay, what am I doing now, then? I don't have my tongs anymore. I got another ember. Mmm, smells delicious. Do you hear it, Miss Appleton? Horses. Growling stomachs. Here they come. Are we feeding people or horses? Ding, ding, ding. Do you think it could be them? I love the little box that comes up with the font and everything. Oh, I got some solid wax. What do I want to do with that? Oh, the tongs are back. Not really. You can't get them. Empty pot. Oh, we put it in the pot. So we're boiling wax. What are we want? Okay. Okay, well, I didn't know that could happen. I don't think there's anything else we can do. Oh, look at these horrifying customers. My god. What the hell? Look! The chest! Okay, that one's a shark or something. And then we got a guy with an octopus on his head. Okay, is the octopus the head of the figure with a guy's head in his mouth, or is the head the guy with an octopus attached to the top of his head? This is very important. These are the men we've been looking for. Find them a place to sit, quickly. We want that chest. And who is talking? So what would the gentleman like to start with? I guess some boiling wax? Mind-controlling fungus. Old man, deadly shark. Ooh, spicy red swordfish. A personal favorite. A mouth-watering delicacy that's healthy as well. Alright, shall we be keeping track of this? The octopus wants the swordfish. They make strange noises. Alright, I'm writing it down just in case we need to remember who gets what. Lots of omega-3. They're gulping like they're eating already. Old man? Excellent choice. Pigeon a la sauce rosé is our chef's specialty. Well, she's the chef. Old man. Pigeon. Do we have all the ingredients for this stuff? Oh god. That sounds disgusting. And the shark wants the hand and tongue stew. Did you hear that, Miss Appleton? Hand and tongue stew. I'm just gonna put H and T. And you thought this recipe wouldn't be appealing to our customers. I was right. You were wrong. So that's a spicy red swordfish for the mind-controlling beast on the left, a pigeon a la sauce rosé for the sick old man on the right, and a fine hen and tongue stew for the dangerous-looking blue shark in the middle. Of course, all serve with our delicious secret sauce. Go on, Mrs. Appleton, go and fetch the ingredients. And don't forget to check out the recipes list on the kitchen's wall if you have any trouble, any problem remembering them. An exotic treat, it says. What happened to my wax? I had it. Oh, wait, I put it in the pot. Alright, so we need stuff. I need a wild. We got the tail. Grab the tail off. We need to cut the tail off of something, right? Swordfish tail. Okay, put more wax in there. That's all I achieved there. Alright, so I need to get a pigeon, a chili pepper, a swordfish. I need to find a way to cut off that swordfish tail. I need a human hand and a slimy tongue. I guess I'm going outside to get all this stuff. I don't know where else I can get it. Maybe it's in the chest. Be patient, Miss Appleton. Be patient. Well, there's a pigeon. No can reach. We'll throw a water jug at it. No, it's not gonna work. What's this lever? The jail door. Maybe we'll find a human hand in there. Alright, I need something. I need a key, I need a something to chop off a swordfish tail, I need something long to get that pigeon. This is dastardly work, but someone's gotta do it. Oh, she can reach it a little better this time. Oh my god, his head fell off! Poor old Pete. I always knew he'd lose his head sooner or later. Wet boot. Just what we need. Can we take his hand to use for the hand and tongue stew? What am I gonna do with a wet boot? I mean, I want the fishing pole to grab the pigeon with. We can't get that. Life is meaningless. We can't get it. I'm gonna throw a wet boot at it. Take this, pigeon.
Sorry.
She said sorry? What do you mean sorry? We feed people hands and stuff. That's the main ingredient for our pigeon supreme a la sauce rosé. Now let's finish the dish. You spelled rosé differently this time. wooden cart. I hope you're not thinking of climbing up there. Oh, we already got the pigeon. Alright, so we've got a blue pigeon. Do we feed one person, or do we try to get all the ingredients first? Because I don't know how to get ingredients. Anything else? Or what we've done. Alright, maybe we'll just make it. I mean, what's that on the ground? Oh, it's gone. Never mind then. Alright, we gotta make this then. Oh, I don't want that. I couldn't figure out how to get her to move. Alright. Pigeon. Cover with the special sauce. Blue pigeon. Okay. Well done, Miss Appleton. The pigeon a la sauce rosé is ready to be served. Cover it with wax. Alright, well, I guess we're gonna give it to them. Can't spice it up a little bit? Never mind then. Okay, so it's the old man that wanted the pigeon. Bon appetit, monsieur. Monsieur, rather. He died? You can tell by his pale face that he really enjoyed his last supper. What's in the special sauce? Cyanide or something? Don't worry, they are used to pass out in taverns. Okay. They won't notice he stopped breathing. Oh, alright. That's fine then. We got rusty scissors. Okay. Next stuff then, I guess? Okay. I thought we were gonna let the boat go. I'm like, what are we doing with scissors? Trap door. We can't go further that way. Captain's cabin. Let's go in here first. Oh my god, I saw her skeleton. What kind of being is she? Someone who doesn't know what to do with puddles. Oh, we found a chili pepper for the other thing. This seedling looks completely parched. We'll need to find a nice drink. Well, I do have an empty water jug. But it's an empty water jug. Ah, apply to puddle. Okay. It's really gonna grow that quickly? Alright then. One chili pepper. Oh, it was in the captain's cabin. Is the captain in here? Oh, he's dead. Look at that. I think I know this guy. Let me taste his blood. What? How do I let you taste his blood? Sip? Oh, yes, indeed. Who tasted the blood, her or the narrator? Captain Clint McMurray. My sister's second husband. Okay. Who is talking? Looks like you won't be beating anyone up ever again, Clint. Righto. Alright, we got a butcher knife and a chili pepper. That's a very unceremonious way of getting up and down places. Game sure is different, you know that much. I just want to find my way in here. I guess that's for the last ingredient. Alright, so who wanted the chili pepper? Oh, and the swordfish, right? Chili pepper and the swordfish? Oh, we have the knife to cut off the swordfish's tail. Righto. Yep, that'll do it. One blue swordfish tail, add one chili pepper, and cover with special sauce. All right. Oh, you want to put this in there first? Wait, wait, wait. The special sauce should be added at the end, Miss Appleton. Just follow the recipe. Are we putting it in boiling wax, then? What are we doing? Wait. No? Okay. Well, she doesn't want to put that in. Oh, maybe I have to just combine the items here. Oh, okay. Perfect. Those are the main ingredients. Now let's finish the dish. Spicy blue swordfish. Okay. Plunk. That song is so out of place. It's so funny, though. Well done, Miss Appleton. Our spicy red swordfish is ready to be served. Oh boy. So who gets that? The octopus does. Or mind-controlling fungus, whatever. Bon appetit! Mm-hmm. He is licking it with its giant tongue. Oh yes, a satisfied stomach. This delicatessen is a pleasure worth dying for. And there's the keys that fell out for the jail. So, we can find someone's hand and tongue. Haha, do you get it, Miss Appleton? It's funny. Come on, laugh! Righto. Alright. Jailer keys. Whoop! It's like completely demented, yet we're adding in cute sound effects for different things. Like whimsical at the same time. What's the lever? We don't know. Alright, let's add to the jail door. Oh boy. That's a bony hand. Do we need something with a little more meat on it? I guess not. Where do we find a tongue? An octopus guy? Can use his tongue. That was a long tongue that came out of him. Or her. Or it. Or something. Let's see if we can get that. Slimy tongue. There you go. Because the recipe did call for a slimy tongue. Not any other kind of tongue, like a dry one or anything. Just very convenient it has it be one slimy tongue and one plump human hand. That's not plump, that's a bone. It'll have to do, I guess. We're not combining it like the other thing? Maybe we need to make it cover with wax because it's not plump? Oh, okay. Haha! We made it plump, wax hand. There we go. Now let's finish the dish! Wax hand and tongue. It's funny every time. Well done, Miss Appleton. The hand and tongue stew is ready to be served. What the hell have I come to in this life? We're serving hand and tongue stews. Bon appetit, my cartilaginous friend. Ah, another satisfied customer. Such a tasty delicacy can't help but defeat even the most discerning of stomachs. Well done, Miss Appleton. The service was impeccable. I don't think our customers have any complaints, do they? Well, no, they're dead. Great. Now let's clean all this mess before the stench gets the attention of the authorities. I guess we're adding him to the secret sauce? We still can't open that. He's not hungry. Well, we need to gather them, you said. I don't know how we gather them to stop the authorities from being alerted. Oh. It's raining blood from a lacerated sky. Letting its horror, creating my structure. Okay. Great idea, Miss Appleton. This will be useful to carry the bodies out. It's just wonderful. Dum-de-dum. Dum-de-doom. 10 fathoms deep on the road to hell. Yo-ho and a bottle of... Oh, here you are. The narrator getting bored. Oh, we're turning the lever then, huh? Oh, I can't even walk anywhere. Okay. We have never used a grinder with such large specimens. Let's hope their bones don't get stuck. Oh my god! We've recycled them. Well done, Miss Appleton. You performed diligently. Thank you. What's in the chest? A ghost. There's a ghost in the chest. A body and a ghost. And she's asleep. Because this always happens. Thank you, Ms. Appleton. I appreciate all you've done for me. Oh, is that the narrator? The ghost? At last, I'm allowed to rest, and so are you. I have so many good memories of you and I working side by side. Oh, is he the old chef? Well, she used to have normal-looking skin, first of all. You are my dearest friend. He was talking to her from beyond the grave. When those beasts dragged me out from our kitchen, I knew I was done for. I swear I didn't steal that gold nugget from them. I won it fair and square. Huh. While I was anguishing, suffocating inside this chest they put me in, there was only one thing I knew for certain. You wouldn't rest until you found me, dead or alive. I'm deeply sorry you had to lose your own sanity along the way. Please, find a quiet place to bury my bones, near the old well, where I like to spend time. That's kind of sad. Wow. It's time for me to leave, Miss Appleton. Sweet dreams, my dear friend. And goodbye. Oh, that's so sad, though. Huh. Who knew it would turn out like this? Well, I really like the music in this one. Anyway, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I'm going to be playing more of his games. Sticking them in here and there. So I hope to see you guys in another Let's Play. And always, seek adventure.